Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your afternoon episode 555, part 2, Daily Bread Passage. The title for today is We Need Our Community Church. And this is your Wednesday, December the 1st, 2021, Daily Bread Passage. That's right. It's December 1st, everybody. Welcome to a new month. This is your first daily bread passage for December. And like I said, episode 555, part 2. So we need our community church from John Blase, however you want to pronounce it. I know I'm butchering, I'm just saying it the way I think it's gonna come off. But if you're excited about the first Daily Bread passage, smash that like button. Comment what you like about the Daily Bread and what you hate about it. But please give at least a positive disapproval of what you don't like. Subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, and share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that goal of 100 subscribers by January the 15th. I know it can be done. Why is my eyes looking so daggone drowsy? My eyes look so heavy in the picture. But I guess it's just the way the light is and making me squint a little bit, but that's fine. Okay. This passage today comes from Hebrews chapter 10, verses 19 to 25. John writes, I grew up the firstborn son of a Southern Baptist preacher. Every Sunday the expectation was clear. I was to be in church. Possible expectations? Maybe if I had a significant fever. But the truth is I absolutely loved going and I went a few times feverish. But the world has changed and the numbers for regular church attendance are not what they used to be. Of course, the quick question is why? The answers are many and varied. And author Kathleen Norris counters those answers with a response she received from a pastor to the question, why do we go to church? He said, we go to church for other people because someone may need you there. So now by no means is the only reason we go to church. But his response does resonate with the heartbeat of the writer to Hebrews. He urges the believers to persevere in the faith and to achieve that goal. He stressed not giving up meeting together, Hebrews 10:25, which says, let us not give up meeting together as some in the habit of doing, but encourage one another. Why, you may ask? Because something vital would be missed in our absence. And encouraging one another, verse 25 again, we need that mutual agreement, encouragement, to spur one another on toward love and good deeds. Verse 24, the previous verse to that one. So brothers and sisters, keep meeting together, because someone may need you there. And the corresponding truth is that you may need them as well. Amen. So what are the top four reasons you either go to church or don't go? One of them that I don't go. Vehicle. Right now, vehicle. But another one that we never go because it just got, in a way, the people in our church and our church family seems like they were favoring part of the church here, but they weren't favoring you. It's like you were being, what do they call that? You still got response from them, when you call them, but when you, like say, if you wanted to do a song special at during one of the services, you had to pass it along to the person doing the music or behind the music setup, and then you pray that you don't get in, because sometimes it just may not work out. But then there's others in the church, in the church family, that they drop the hat, they get to do song specials. They don't have to do nothing. But yet you have to do a song check, because the song you want to do, you have to take it to the person in charge of the music, of setting the music up during the services, and has to get a double check before you can get cleared. That was another reason that we stopped going. Well, the driver stopped going. My brother stopped going because that's the way he felt, like he was being outcasted. Or there's another word I'm trying to say, but I can't remember it. Like he was being shunned. I could see it certain times, but other times I was just enjoying being with church family. Some of the ones that are there have been in that church for as long as I can remember, and I enjoyed going there every week, seeing them, saying hello, how you doing, how was your week, and things like that. You know, you enjoy going to see your friends, your church friends, and asking them how their week was and how they're doing. And then when you parted ways on Sunday, you would say, have a good week. See you next. Or if you would never go until the next Sunday, you say, see you next Sunday. You say, see you next week. It's like, you look forward to seeing your friends. Your church friends, more or less what I call it. Sorry, I'm trying to change the angle a little bit. I was getting a little blurriness under the bottom corner. Is it just my shirt doing it? It may be just my shirt doing it, but that was a few of the reasons why I wasn't going. But so how does knowing someone may need you there make you feel about meeting together? So say this: Heavenly Father, as I meet with others to worship and praise your name, help me to also encourage others in your name. Forgive me when I overlook the latter because I'm not too preoccupied with myself. So learn more about the importance of church at this website. I will remember to put it in the description box. DiscoverySeries.org/Q0904. Q0 or O, like I usually say it, 9004. That's DiscoverySeries.org/Q0904. Zero. The zero O. Not the regular, not the letter O. But just sometimes I call, like say if I got a 3-digit letter and it's a number, and it's both numbers have different numbers and the middle is a zero, I go, like say you got 904, like you got 904, I say 904. In the phone number, that's the way I do it. If I've got a zero in there, if there's a, like in my number, part of my number, my last four, I have a zero in there. So when I say the number and that third number in, I'll say my number and I go 09. So that's just the way that's the way sometimes I say zero, but. So your Bible reading is Ezekiel chapter 40 and 41. Ezekiel must be a long book. And then 2 Peter chapter 3. So we're just picking right up where we left off yesterday, right along with it. So, coming up in tomorrow's part 2 of episode 556 for Thursday, December the 2nd, your Daily Bread, Celebrating Diversity, from Lisa M. Samra again. We just had her just a few days ago. And that one comes from Psalm 133. So, coming up later tonight in your first turning point of December, I'll read the beginning part at the beginning of the thing about the month. But your first one is Sunlight on Our Path. In episode 99, just coming up on Thursday, is episode 100 for the turning point. But basically these are going to consist of devotions from the book of 1 John. That's where it's consisting of. So 1 John 1:6 is your beginning verse on this one, titled Sunlight on Our Path. Your recommended reading is 1 John chapter 1. A.W. Tozer has your turning point, and you're continuing on in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 through 13. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later tonight after 7. So I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy the month of December. If you didn't hear that, if you didn't watch this morning's video, hope you have a very, very blessed month of December. And I'll probably say that again in your turning point, just in case you didn't hear it, in case you didn't hear me do it in this one, or the morning one. I'll do it again that way. That's the first day, so. But I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your glorious Hump Day Wednesday afternoon. Come back this evening for your Wednesday, your first Wednesday, or for your Wednesday turning point, the first one of December. With all these today, the first of December. So stay tuned, and I'll see y'all later.